السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة، فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال، رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نذر المغشي عليه من الموت، فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف، فلو عزم الأمر طاعة وقول معروف، فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم. فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم؟ أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم. أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها؟ إن الذين ارتدوا على أدبارهم من بعد ما تبين لهم الهدى الشيطان سول لهم وأملى لهم. ذلك بأنهم قالوا للذين كرهوا ما نزل الله سنطيعكم في بعض الأمر، والله يعلم إسرارهم. فكيف إذا توفتهم الملائكة يضربون وجوههم وأدبارهم؟ ذلك بأنهم اتبعوا ما أسخط الله وكرهوا رضوانه فأحبط أعمالهم. أم حسب الذين في قلوبهم مرض أن لن يخرج الله أضغانهم؟ ولو نشاء لأريناكهم فلعرفتهم بسيماهم، ولتعرفنهم في لحن القول، والله يعلم أعمالهم. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله حمدا يوافي نعمه ويكافئ مزيده. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. سبحانك اللهم لا أحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ذو العزة والجبروت والملكوت والكبرياء والعظمة. وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم عبده ورسوله، بلغ عن الله رسالاته ونصح له في برياته، فجزاه الله خير ما جزى نبيا عن أمته. اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه صلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمين إلى يوم الدين. اللهم طهر أعمالنا من الرياء، وقلوبنا من النفاق، وأعيننا من الخيانة يا رب العالمين، وارزقنا الإخلاص والصدق والمتابعة والسداد فيما نقول ونفعل يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. Dear Muslim brothers and sisters, we thank Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala for his countless bounties, and we ask for more. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the one who has showered on us his blessings. All that we have has come from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and we ought to thank him and appreciate Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. A true Muslim is the one who is obedient to Allah, who submits his will to the creator of the universe. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the one who has created each and everything in this world. The earth, the stars, the mountains, whatever we see. Allah asks us in the Holy Book, هَلْ مِنْ خَالِقٍ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ. Is there any other creator apart from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala? The answer is clear, no. It's only him subhanahu wa ta'ala who is the creator, the cherisher, the sustainer, the organizer of everything. A person who refracts in front of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and bows in front of his Lord, hoping the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and willing to be among the servants whom Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will take to paradise, is the one who will get eternal bliss and success in this world and in the hereafter. But the one who disobeys Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, who never submits his will to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, who never pays heed, who never follows the command of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, then he will wait for nothing apart from destruction, which will come from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Among the qualities of a true Muslim is that he or she should always be truthful. A Muslim is not the one who lies or belies the sayings of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. A Muslim believes in whatever that comes from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and among his attributes is that he is truthful always. The Prophet salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi says, ayatul munafiqi thalath idha hadatha kadab. The signs of the hypocrite are three, among his signs that is. The first sign is that whenever he tells a story, or whenever he talks, or he has to lie. But a Muslim is not a liar. A Muslim is truthful. A Muslim adheres to the advice which has come from the Prophet salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi, that is, alaykum bis-sidq. You have to be truthful always. In your dealings, you have to be truthful. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has made among his attributes truth. He says, وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا. Who is more truthful than Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? No one. He tells us only that which is the reality. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala speaks only of the fact. And whatever that has come from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is the reality. It's the original thing. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has chosen prophets from among his mankind, and he has made them truthful as well. They never lie. Whatever they speak is the truth that is from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah says, talking of Prophet Ibrahim as an example, alayhi wa ala nabiyyina salatu wa salam, wadhkur fil kitabi Ibrahim innahu kana siddiqan nabiyya. And remember in the book Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, he was a truthful prophet sent by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The highest level of truthfulness is being truthful with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Yes, it is required that we are truthful in your dealings with the fellow mankind. But the highest level of truth is being truthful when dealing with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You are truthful in your deeds. You are truthful in your faith. You are truthful in that you obey Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. There is no doubt in your faith. There is no uncertainty in your iman. You are a person who truly believes in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and is truthful with him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala uplifts those servants who are truthful with him. And there is no doubt that he will punish those who are not truthful with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Among the verses that were just read before the lecture, فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala talks about the hypocrites. He says, If they could have been truthful with their Lord, that could have been better for them. Dear Muslim brothers and sisters, let us ask ourselves today, how truthful are we when it comes to dealing with Allah? How truthful are we when we are performing ibadah? How truthful are we when we are told to abstain from everything that has been prohibited by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? How truthful are we? How do we abstain from that, or do we go ahead in fulfilling that? Do we obey the commands of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, or do we not? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has said in the holy book, qala Allah, hadha يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم. هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم. The conclusion of Surah Al-Ma'idah, when Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has talked about the day of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has questioned Prophet Isa, the story, when he was finishing the story, when the surah is finishing the story of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will say in the day of judgment, this is the day when those who were truthful will benefit and profit from their truth. They will get profit from their truth. Now, they used to perform the prayers, pay zakah or sadaqah, obedient to the parents. They never used to disturb fellow Muslims. They were on the straight path, following Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, adhering to the rules and regulations laid down by the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then on the day of judgment, they will not be punished by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. They will not face the wrath of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. But today we claim to be Muslims, wa nastaghfirullah. We say aloud we are Muslims. But walil asaf, we are Muslims just by appearance. We are Muslims just by names. We are Muslims just by the environment in which we live. But we don't have the true qualities and the attributes of a Muslim. Dear Muslim brothers and sisters, it was an order given to the Prophet salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi to go to the war of Tabuk. Long journey with a lot of stress and problems and hardships. Among the companions of the Prophet salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi who never went for the battle was Ka'b ibn Malik. When the Prophet returned from the battle, salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi, everyone who never went for the war came to give an excuse. Ka'b ibn Malik was among the ones who never went for the war. Then he came to the masjid. He sat in front of the Prophet salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi. Then the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam asked him, "Oh Ka'b, why didn't you go with us? Didn't you prepare yourself before we set off for the journey?" He said, "Ya Rasulullah, if I could have been in front of any other person, I could have lied. And I don't want to lie to you. For if I lie to you, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala may reveal verses which will clarify to you that I am lying. I will just say the truth and nothing but the truth. There was no time when I was able to go than that time. I was ready. I don't have any excuse, Ya Rasulullah. I will tell you the truth, hoping that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will forgive me." And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala revealed verses which were read, are being read, and will be read till the day of judgments. Talking about the story of those three men. They were noble and righteous, truthful with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala granted them the forgiveness which they wanted, and in the hereafter they will dwell in paradise. Bidnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. A man from the Bedouin came to the Prophet salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi, and as he was with the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, there was some wealth which was got from a battle which the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam and his companions fought. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam gave each and every person a share of the wealth. This person or this man never took his share. He said, I did not follow you because of wealth. But I want to go to war with you, to go for jihad with you, Ya Rasulallah. And the arrow strikes my throat, and Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is pleased with me. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said to him, if you are truthful, then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will make your wish come true. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and his companions went for another battle. After the war was over, the man was brought to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam when he was already killed, and the arrow struck him in the place which he pointed before his death. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, he was truthful with Allah, and Allah granted him his wish. If you are truthful with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah will grant you each and everything you want. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will fulfill all your wishes, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will give you whatever you desire. That is if you are truthful with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Then a true Muslim should always be truthful with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in his dealings, in his actions, in his words, hoping for the reward of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and the mercy and the blessings of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala.